So in this video, we are taking a look at this JTS line attenuator, where you can attenuate a line level signal, hopefully to a mic level signal, or I believe it's made actually for microphones that are a little too hot. So you can attenuate them a little bit if they are going a little too hot into your mixer or recording device. So this one is from JST, the MA123. It's a very inexpensive little device. It's a XLR cable, or not cable, but plug, with some settings. I believe it can attenuate all the way down to 30 dB. And yeah, comes in this nice little white box here. So let's actually just get into it and unbox it. I am recording into my mixer. I have a Bose mixer right down here, but the signal is only line level. I cannot attenuate it enough to get straight into my camera. So I have to go through a recording device like this, like the Zoom H1N, which is a nice little handy recorder. But if I actually take the signal out of this one here and get it into my camera, I get a lot of noise from this little preamp here, a lot of white noise. So not the greatest preamp, well, at least when it comes to attenuating a line level signal here in to the device, or to a mic level signal into the camera. I'm getting too much noise, and I've tried other solutions like small on-camera mixers, where you can you know, turn down the volume or the level of the line level signal. But anyways, this one I hope will do the job, attenuate the signal around 30 dB. Other things I've tried have just created noise onto the signal, a lot of static noise going into the camera, connecting them through different devices like other recorders and such. So I'm hoping to get a clean signal in with this one here, because it is kind of hard still to go from line level to mic level. And you can see here the little quick start instructions here. It should be fairly simple, and I believe it is completely passive, so it doesn't require any phantom power or anything like that, at least to my knowledge. But yeah, you can see the settings here. You can attenuate 10 dB, 20 dB, or 30 dB. And full metal case, optimized shielding from hum. And that's exactly the hum I've had with other devices I've tried. Let me just go get the little mixer I've tried. I've tried this little on-camera mixer here, which have just two volume rockers. And you can get either mono in or stereo in, and just, of course, take the signal out here and get into the camera. So from mixer to camera, I can turn the volume down enough, but it just gives me that hum noise with this one here. And of course, it's completely unbalanced. And probably I could try some better cables. But yeah, I hope this one here from JTS will do the job, because it will be balanced out of my mixer into this device here. And of course, maybe just have a small cable going into the camera, so hopefully it won't have any hum noise. I do have a lot of static noise here. I believe it's from my Wi-Fi router or whatever. Other microphones I have issues also connecting to my cameras. If I connect them, I get the hum noise. So poorly shielded the microphone, the Rode Go wire, not wireless, but the Rode shotgun microphone, video mic Go, I have the same issue with get a hum and then connect that to my camera. But anyways, within the little box there, we get, of course, the device itself, nice and wrapped in some plastic, and some anti-moisture thingies in there as well. And there's a little tape covering here. Let's just get a little knife and cut through that. But yeah, overall, this little device here feels pretty good. It is definitely made of metal. Well, if you can hear that, it is very light actually. Feels like aluminium. But this is, of course, the busy end here, where you have the attenuating levels. You just set this with your switch. Of course, I'm going to go minus 30 dB. I believe it requires minus 40 dB going from line to mic level, but I can of course turn down the volume quite a bit on my mixer and also on the camera as well. So I'm hoping this this 30 dB will be enough. But I believe it's designed originally to just go onto a microphone. And if the microphone is too hot, of course, you can attenuate the signal a little bit here. But input is the female plug here. And of course, output here onto the male plug. And yeah, balanced in, and I'm going to run it unbalanced out. I do have actually the cable right here. It is a rather long cable at the moment, but that's the only thing I have, but it's 3.5 millimeter TRS. So stereo or balanced or whatever you want to use it for. And of course, female XLR in one end. So that's at least my plan for now. Of course, if this works, I will just get a shorter cable because yeah, I only have really short distance. My mixer is right down here. I can touch it and my camera is, you know, right over here. So I don't really need such a long cable as the one I have right here. But this is of course just the output. And for input here, out of my mixer, I have TRS. So this is a big jack. It's a 6.5 millimeter. Remember, and of course male XLR. So going into the actual device, the little thingy here, attenuator, just like so. It is a little maybe big here, but yeah, if this works, I definitely hope it will. My other solution is I've ordered some monitors, video assist from Blackmagic Design, should be coming next week, so I can run balanced line level into that monitor. The 7-inch monitor has mini XLR, and it does accept line level, so, but it will still be nice to just be able to record straight into the camera and don't have to use an external recorder. So if I could use both options, that would be quite nice. This one is very inexpensive. So yeah, of course I will share some affiliate link in the description below, but it's just this little round XLR, long XLR plug here. I'm not really sure what it consists inside, but some resistors and capacitors or whatever. But it actually feels like pretty high quality. I believe Shure and ElectroVoice also makes versions of this. The Shure one only had down to minus 25 dB, and it cost like more than twice as much as this one here. So yeah, I'm going to try this one, and the same as the other device from ElectroVoice. Yeah, one of the other Audio-Technica, I believe it's called. Oh, they have made one as well. But yeah, the MA123. So let me just actually stop the video here. Try and plug all this cable mess into my camera here. Play around with the levels and get back, hopefully recording straight into the camera. So see you in a second. So I have connected the JTS here to my mixer. So line level sent to, I'm also recording onto my little Zoom recorder here as well, because sadly I still get that humming sound. Just take a listen here to the recording going straight through this here from my mixer. Yeah, I get this buzzing humming sound. I'm not really sure why, if there's some static in the room here. Like I said, I have a quite powerful router. Maybe that's causing some issues, but I also have issues with other microphones that is poorly shielded. My Rode Wireless Go, it also gets this buzz. Going straight into the Zoom recorder from the same mixer, same gain level or same level on my mixer. I set it to 5% on both of the line outputs. No issues going into something like this, but as soon as I connect my mixer to my camera through either this here, one here, or the one here from Andor or whatever other devices I've tried, I just get that annoying hum sound. If anybody knows a solution for this, let me know down in the comment below. The only solution I think really is going for a external recorder that can also handle line level signal. I don't really have enough money to spend on cameras that can handle such signal, and fortunately, Og unfortunately, the A6400 just cannot do that as well as my old Panasonic cameras. So I'm kind of stuck with this one here, but I have some Blackmagic external recorders on the way with balanced XLR inputs. So I can run straight line level balanced into that one, and of course just run a record externally, which is probably the way I will go in the future. So yeah, unfortunately this little device here doesn't solve the problem if you want to run a line level signal or from line level to mic level into your camera. I also have another device on order from a guy on eBay that makes these little black boxes with mini jack, so small TRS plug in each end, so you can attenuate the signal 40 dB. But I have a feeling that will just cause the same issues as this one. Unfortunately, there is something else going on. Maybe it's the power source going into the camera. Maybe it's interference with wireless communicated devices, or whatever it is. I am definitely keen on hearing anybody's suggestion down in the comment below. But in terms of build quality and construction of this little device here, I think it's quite nice. It's completely passive, so you can run it, like I said, without phantom power, any batteries at all. So if you have a microphone that's a little hot, it is definitely a device I would recommend. And I will put the link down in the description below. But if you want to solve a problem like me, going from line level to mic level and hopefully get a clean signal into a camera, unfortunately, that's not really a device for you or for me. But yeah, that's pretty much all I had for this video. Hope to see you again in a future one. Until then, take care.